back to the Orange Bowl, everybody, and welcome to our good friend Ken Tomash, who spent some time with us at WCTV.
A little time.
Yeah, you missed it. Ken is now the sports director at the CBS affiliate in Fort Myers. You thought you could get away from us. You couldn't.
Oh, well, I think, Scott, if I was really any good, you'd be coming on my show instead of the other way around, but I'm glad to be here and good to see you again.
Well, from your perspective on the West Coast, you've been able to see up close and personal quarterback you develop here in Miami.
Yeah, Scott, but I'd like to start off by talking about the quarterback they don't talk about too much in Miami, the guy they don't tell you about in the media guide. He checked in at 5'8 and 140 pounds. This was 10 years ago and completed all five of his passes as a collegiate. Two of them were to the other team. Yeah, I know. But yes, folks, it was none other than Scott Atwell, junior varsity quarterback, 1980, who had to get into the broadcast booth a little bit earlier than a lot of other athletes.
Oh, my, oh, my.
Scary that's, stuff, huh?
That's like horror film material. Oh, well, fortunately, they are no longer here at Miami recruiting their quarterbacks out of the sports information office.
Well, you talk about recruiting. They didn't have to go too far to get their starting quarterback now just up the road in West Palm Beach. And, you know, over the last 10 years, the Seminoles have faced them all, from Jim Kelly to Bernie Kosar, Vinny Testaverde, even Mike Rodrique and Gino Toretta. But they have never gone up against the guy they're going to face today. And Craig Erickson just might turn out to be the best of the bunch.
I honestly don't want to take the field unless I feel that I'm better than the opposing quarterback.
Craig Erickson hasn't had to worry much about that feeling in his Hurricane career. Not surprisingly, Miami's 11-1 in the 12 games he's started the last 2 years. What is surprising is, despite growing up in West Palm Beach, Erickson never once traveled down I-95 to see the Canes play in the Orange Bowl. In fact, he strongly considered going to Georgia. But Erickson finally made his decision to come to UM, based not on the great quarterbacks of Miami's past, but on how great he thought his future could be here.
Well, it was a gut feeling. It had a lot to do with the coaches. I think the coaching staff under Jimmy Johnson was outstanding, and there was something that I wanted to be a part of. And to be the best quarterback I could have been, I felt that I had to go under them.
In only his second full season, Erickson has a shot at becoming Miami's all-time leader in touchdown passes. With three against Iowa last week, he has 31 scoring tosses, closing in on Vinny Testaverde's record of 48.
I think every game he's going to step higher. You know, he's making a better reads than he did in the beginning of the year. He's getting a lot more time because of the offensive line. And if you get a lot of time, I think you're going to work well back there.
The million-dollar scoreboard here at the Orange Bowl is brand new, but great play at the quarterback position is very familiar. Now, like Bernie Kosar and Steve Walsh, Craig Erickson won a national championship in his first season as the Hurricanes' starting quarterback. Neither of the other guys could repeat the trick the next year, so Erickson wants to do them one better. But you kind of get the feeling Erickson takes that to mean more than just winning another title.
As a player, it's a real challenge to be mentioned to those guys, and as an individual, as a person, it's an honor because they're outstanding individuals. They do a lot for the community, they do a lot for our program, and that's the foundation that happened that we've gotten to be quarterback you.
Another of quarterback U's Phi Beta Pasa graduates thinks the new kid's undergraduate work is worthy of high marks. No tutoring needed.
When things are going good, I don't think you should give any advice to anybody. So he's doing a great job, and as long as he remains doing the things that he's doing, he's going to be successful.
Successful? That's not enough at quarterback U. Craig Erickson won't be satisfied until he and the Hurricanes are number one.
Good, but I guess the real acid test will be, what do the pros think about it? Can he be the fifth number one draft pick?
It is possible. You see, the pros love to come down here. They know the tradition of turning out not only good college quarterbacks, but starting quarterbacks in the NFL. I think Craig Erickson will be a number one pick next year. How well he does in this game in front of a national audience, in front of a number two ranked team, will go a long way towards determining that as well.
Ken, always a pleasure seeing you.
Thanks for joining us on the show.
Okay, when we come back, we'll talk to the guys who are bringing this football game to the nation, the folks at CBS Sports. Stay with us, live from the Orange Bowl.